सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं रूपशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं भद्रायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मुक्तिभेदविभागिने नमोऽव्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः. सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै. ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः. धातुब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृतं सुस्वन्तादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः. नारायणपरो व्यक्तादण्डमव्यक्तसम्भवम् अण्डस्यान्तस्तु मे लोकाः सप्तद्वीपा च मेदिनी. We just looked at the basic meaning of 3.5, which was introduced as kasmat punah karanat karma sanyasa matra deva kevalat jnana rahitat siddhim naishkarmya lakshanam purusho na adigacchati iti hetvakankshayam aha. What is the hetvakanksha? Hetvakanksha meaning the reasoning. There is a curiosity in reasoning. There is a questioning of for what reason. Reason for what? Why purushaha naishkarmya lakshanam siddhim na adigacchati. One does not attain this siddhi which is bereft of any action because the person is krita kritya. And why that kind of siddhi won't accrue to a person who has taken to sannyasa. Sannyasa as in that karma sannyasa, which is karma sannyasa matra, kevala karma sannyasa, which is bereft of jnana, which is without jnana. So that reasoning is expected, and such an expectancy is fulfilled by the 3.5 shloka, which said, Nahi kashchit kshanam api jhatu tishtatya karma krut karyate hevashak karma sarva prasatir jair gunaihi. This is a little confusing in terms of it is karmani all right, but karyate, if it is with kru dhati, we will see kriyate. Karyate is, the dhatu is not kru. Dhatu is kari, which is derived from kru. So it is a sananta dhatu, nijanta dhatu. So karyate karmani prayoga, but it is kru plus nich. Dukrunj karane plus nich will give you, nich will give you kari. Kari, and kari means what? To. So kru is to do. Dukrunj. Dukrunj karane. Dukrunj karane. Sorry. Karane means to do. And this dhatu, kari, will mean to make to do, to cause to do. Cause to do, cause or so causative. Make. And then kari plus. Kari plus karmani. Karmani yak, and then you see karmani. Yak plus te. Te taatamja. So that nahi kashchit kshanam api jatu tishtati akarmakrut. So this initial sentence is easy. Initial sentence is what? Na tishtati. Na tishthati, one cannot remain, kashchit shanav, kashchit na tishthati, kashchit, any person, na he can be seen as yasmat, so because or since kashchit api purusha avyaya, but prathamarthe kashchit api kashchit kshanam api, not even for a moment. So momentarily, jatu means kadachid, whenever, and never. So if you take na, kadachid, kashchit, kadachid api, nahi tishtati, jatu tishtati, na tishtati, means one cannot remain akarmakrut, akarmakrut krut san na tishtati. one cannot remain as a as not being without any karma. Kashchit kashchit kshanamapi kshanamapi, even for a moment, kshanamapi and jatu jatu na tishtati kadachidapi kadachidapi kshanamapi na tishtati, not even for a moment, not ever. So never can one remain without any karma. Jatu na tishtati, what? Akarma, akarma krit san, san na tishtati, being as a as one without karma. This is what Naj Tatpurusha. Na karma krit. First upapada tatpurusha, karma karoti iti karma krit. So upapada tatpurusha, then Naj Tatpurusha. न कर्मकृत अकर्मकृत सो कश्चित् क्षणमपि जातु न तिष्ठति अकर्मकृत अकर्मकृत न तिष्ठति वन कैन नॉट रिमेन बीइंग विदाउट एनी कर्म एंड देन कार्यते कार्यते इज व्हाट यू हैव टू लुक फॉर कार्यते कर्मणि प्रयोग सो यू हैव टू लुक एट कर्मा इन फर्स्ट ग्रेस सो ही इज एन अव्यय अवश्य अवशः अवशः इज फर्स्ट केस सो अवशः एंड सर्वः सर्वः इज इन फर्स्ट केस अवशः इज इन फर्स्ट केस कर्म हियर कर्म कर्म इज आल्सो कर्म इज कर्म बट इट इज कर्मा टू दी क्रू क्रू धातु इट इज नॉट कर्मा टू कार्य धातु सो कार्य धातु हैज वन कर्म विच इज कॉजेटिव This Kari Dhatu and the Antargata Dhatu, the Dhatu inside Kari is Kru. So for that the Karma is Karma, this word Karma here. So this will go in second case. Sarva Prakriti Jair Gunaihi and this is Karta, in Karmani Prayoga Karta goes in third case. So Gunaihi Karyate, Gunaihi Prakriti Jair Gunaihi, Prakriti Jair Gunaihi are what? The Karmas which are born from Prakriti. Born of Prakriti or born from Prakriti. This is Panchami Tatpurusha. Prakritihe Jataha. Prakritihe Jataha and Taihi Prakriti Jaihi. Prakriti Jaihi Gunaihi. This Gunas which are born of Prakriti. Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. These are the three Gunas. Sattva, Rajas and Tamas will, when Sattva is active, a person will can do Dhyana Ityadi or any धार्मिक कार्य आई एम जस्ट गिविंग अ बेसिक दिस थिंग इट इज मच मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड देन दैट एंड देन रजस इज इफ इट इज एक्टिव देन अ पर्सन गेट्स टू सम एक्टिविटी राजसिक प्रवृत्ति विल कम ऑफ दिस रजोगुण एंड देन तामसिक गुण व्हेन इट इज एक्टिव व्हेन इट इज प्रिडोमिनेंट देन अ पर्सन वुड गो टू स्लीप सो यू कैन नॉट से दैट द गुणाज आर however the gunas are, but I'll be different. You cannot be. You have to. You can control the gunas, but you have to be trained for that. Otherwise, gunas control you. Therefore, gunaihi sarvaha karyate. Everyone karyate means what? Everyone is made to do. So here, if you say is made to do. Yeah, you can say yeah, everyone is made to act, let's say act, or made to do karma, made to perform, let's say perform what action? So this action will be karma to that, to kri dhatu, and kari dhatu's karma is sarva. So sarva we can translate everyone is made to perform. Indeed, everyone is made to perform karma, and avasha itself has a meaning helplessly. So everyone helplessly. Who is helpless? Actually, everyone being helpless, or you can say helplessly. Everyone is made to perform action, but that action person sarvaha, everyone. Or all are made to perform. So if you translate this as all, then you would expect a plural in English. But this sarva, you can be translated as everyone also. So everyone is helpless when influenced by gunas. Therefore, gunaihi sarvaha karyate. Everyone is pushed into action by gunas. And what gunas? Prakriti jai gunaihi. Those gunas which are born of prakriti. And everyone has a mix of these three. One is predominant, the other is secondary. In Brahmana, sattva is predominant and rajas is secondary. Tamas is third. In kshatriya, rajas is predominant, sattva is secondary and tamas is third. In a vaishya, rajas is predominant but tamas is secondary and then sattva is third. In a shudra, tamas is predominant, rajas is secondary and sattva is the third. So based on these mix, because a person is indulging in some kind of a karma and trains this mind, body, mind, sense complex to into that, thereby one collects karma phala and vasanas also. These vasanas make a person to be born in a particular sharira, whether a human body or not a human body, whether a devata sharira or a as a tree or as an animal or rakshasa, whatever, or as a human being also in a particular varna. This varna is because of the earlier tendencies. A person while dying picks up some set of karmas because one is interested to do something, thereby a particular gender and a particular form of the body, the roopa of the body, all these are decided by the interests of a person while dying, and those are due to the vasanas which are have been accumulated by the mind by indulging into actions or indulging into particular thinking. So we collect those, and what happens? These gunas will, the way they make, you have no choice of being born in a particular family, in a particular country, as a particular person, in a as a particular gender, all these you have no choice. No choice because you have already chosen. By performing particular actions, we have chosen a set of prarabdha which will give rise to a particular body. And with that, there will be an association. Similarly, while in that body, those gunas will drive the person to act. Because vasanas will bring up these gunas which will come to the forefront. And the effort needed based on the varna is different. Based on the varna, based on the gender, based on circumstances, all these efforts vary from person to person. However, the push from gunas will be there. Therefore, avasha, person becomes helpless, and sarvaha, avashaha, karyate, kaihi, gunaihi, by gunas. So, kartari, gunaihi, in tritiya is kartari, for karyate. So, gunaihi, prakriti jaihi, gunaihi, prakriti jaihi, gunaihi, sarvaha, sarvaha, avashaha, avashaha, sarva, avashaha, sarvaha, all who are helpless now, this, everyone who is helpless due to this reason is the gunas are born of prakriti, and this prakriti, a person is himself made out of these components. Therefore, avashaha sarvaha karyate are made to act. Made to act was karma. Therefore, karma karyate. Sarvaha karma karyate. Difficult to understand unless you know how this karmani works and you also know how the which case it will take based on the nijanta. Based on nijanta and the antargata dhatu. So, thankfully it is only this much, otherwise there could have been more complications, but there are not. So, while reading it may sound a little difficult, but if you understand the cases and how they go into this kari dhatu, then you can make sense out of this. Prakriti jai gunaihi avasha sarva karma karyate. He is missed, so you can just add he, kashchit hi kshanam, and you can say prakriti jai hi gunai hi. Yattu anatmajnyah choditam karma naravate iti tad asat eva iti ah. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara says yattu iti tad asat, whatever is said, iti, वॉट एवर वॉज थॉट अबाउट बाय अर्जुना नाउ. अर्जुना सेज दैट आई विल नॉट एक्ट एट ऑल, सो देर विल बी नो पापा. दिस इज हिज अंडरस्टैंडिंग. सो यत्तु अनात्मज्ञ चोदितं कर्म न आरभते. अनात्मज्ञ वन हु इज हैज आत्मानं न जानाति. आत्मानं जानाति इति आत्मज्ञः एंड न आत्मज्ञः अनात्मज्ञः. सो इट्स अ नञ् तत्पुरुष. फर्स्ट उपपद एंड देन नञ् तत्पुरुष. सो चोदितं कर्म न आरभते. चोदितं इज प्रिस्क्राइब बाय वेदास एज पर अ पर्टिकुलर वर्णाश्रम. अ पर्सन हैज अ पर्टिकुलर ड्यूटी टू फॉलो टू डिलीवर. हैविंग बीन बॉर्न एज अ ह्यूमन बींग यू हैव सर्टन ड्यूटीज. हैविंग बीन बॉर्न इन अ पर्टिकुलर वर्णाश्रम इन अ वर्ण यू हैव सम ड्यूटीज. देन बेस्ड ऑन द आश्रम वन हैज ड्यूटीज. सो दिस चोदितम कर्म विच वेदास हैव गिवन फॉर उद्धार फॉर वन्स ओन प्रोग्रेस टूवर्ड्स मोक्ष. वॉट एवर हैज कर्म हैज बीन प्रिस्क्राइब दैट कर्म आई विल नॉट डू. न आरभते. सो फॉर क्षत्रिय अर्जुन इज सेइंग दैट आई विल नॉट फाइट द बैटल. सो न आरभते इति तद असत. तद असत मीन्स दैट इज रॉन्ग. असत हैज अ मीनिंग ऑफ रॉन्ग हियर. सो दैट इज नॉट राइट. दैट इज नॉट करेक्ट. दैट इज नॉट राइट. सो असत हैज अ मीनिंग ऑफ रॉन्ग देयर. असदेव इंडीड इट इज रॉन्ग एंड दैट इज शोन बाय द नेक्स्ट श्लोक इति आह भगवान. कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य यास्ते मनसा स्मरन् इन्द्रियार्थान् विमूढात्मा मिथ्याचारस्य उच्यते. सो नाउ अर्लियर श्लोका व्हाट हैज बीन सेड इन द अर्लियर श्लोका सेड दैट अ पर्सन विल बी मेड टू एक्ट. नाउ इफ पर्सन सेज दैट आई विल नॉट एक्ट दैट विल नॉट हैपन बिकॉज यू विल बी पुश टू एक्ट. एंड लेट से यू डू नॉट एक्ट फॉर अ व्हाइल. द गुणाज आर एक्टिव बट देन यू डोंट एक्ट. Arjuna may think that I am a Kshatriya, I can control. I have so much of control, he may think, and he'll say that no, I will calm my mind and I will not act. Unless one has Chitta Shuddhi of that level and one can stay with Atma oneself without actually getting indulged into the Sharira itself, Sharira Dharma, unless that happens, it is not possible to stay away from karma. So for a while one may withdraw. And which was said in the second chapter also, one can withdraw. But रसवर्जम रसा विल रिमेन. वासनाज विल नॉट गो एंड वासनाज विल एवरी नाउ एंड देन प्रॉड. इनफैक्ट अ पर्सन हु सेज दैट आई विल नॉट लेट्स से आई विल नॉट फाइट दैट पर्सन इफ द एंगर इज देयर क्रोधा इज देयर द क्रोधा विल कम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ ड्रीम ऑल्सो. फॉर अ फ्यू डेज वन मे पोस्टपोन बट इन अ ड्रीम वन मे हैव नाइटमेयर्स देयर. बट दैट इज नॉट वॉट इज सेड. वॉट इज सेड इज दैट इन वेकिंग one will have to try to control, but then rasa is there, therefore one will be fighting within. So I'm just giving an example in the context of Arjuna, but it is true with anything and everything, for everyone. Karmendriya, if you are trying to take control over, so only dama is there, which is good, but shama is difficult. Shama is control of the अंतरंग साधना. इट इज अंतरंग साधना. यू हैव टू कंट्रोल युअर अंतकरण एंड द इंद्रियाज विच आर नॉट ग्रॉस. दे आर नॉट कर्मेंद्रियाज आर ग्रॉस. यू कैन जस्ट कीप युअर यू कैन जस्ट टाई युअर हैंड्स युअर सेल्फ एंड नॉट एक्ट. बट कर्मेंद्रियाणि संयम्य ओनली दिस कर्मेंद्रियाज. बट ज्ञानेन्द्रिया व्हाट अबाउट ज्ञानेन्द्रिया. ज्ञानेन्द्रियाज विल बी देयर which you cannot control just by tying up or tying together saying that I'll not act. So karmendriyani sanyamya yaha kashchit aste, one who remains, he says that I will remain without actually acting. Good, dama is there, but shama is not there. Therefore manasa smaran, one will be utilizing all the antakarana towards that goal. One will just daydreaming, whatever one is actually wanting to do due to vasanas, and one is not doing it, but still manasa smaranaste. What? Indriyarthan. Indriyarthan, karmendriyani sanyamya, but indriyartha, the arthas of indriyas, indriya vishayas, one keeps on remembering. Smaranaste. manasa, through the mind, one recalls all these indriyarthas, although one really doesn't indulge in these. So daydreams, and then that vimudatma, who is actually a muda, visheshena muda, vimudatma, because she is confused, not only confused that like others, but he thinks that by not actually acting out, I will be okay, but he will not be okay because he will be torturing himself, vimudatma, and thereby deluded that I am okay. That person will not be okay. And mithyacharaha, he is showing off others that I have good dama, but mithyacharaha, saha, mithyachara uchyate, mithyachara, because achara is mithya, mithya means fall, mithya is an avyaya, and mithyacharaha yasya, achara yasya saha mithyacharaha, the person who has, whose conduct is unbecoming, because he, although he is not really acting, in the mind he is, his entire world is there, therefore, सब मिथ्याचारः उच्यते कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम यः आस्ते यः आस्ते वन हु रिमेन्स रिमेन्स एज इन और सिट्स सिट्स डायरेक्टली इफ यू ट्रांसलेट विल बी सिटिंग बट आसन बट वन हु रिमेन्स यः संयम्य आस्ते संयम्य इज लेबन्त यम धातु प्लस त्वा एंड सम पूर्वक वन सम इज एडेड त्वा विल बी रिप्लेस बाय ल्यप therefore sanyamya and sanyamya controlling having controlled what having controlled the karmendriyas therefore second case manasa smaranaste and smarani shatranta smaran manasa smaranaste through the mind recalling through the mind recalling what indriyarthan so smrudhatu this smaran smrudhatu has karma as इंद्रियार्थान इंद्रियाणानाम अर्थ अर्थान षष्ठी तत्पुरुष सविमूढात्मा मिथ्याचार उच्यते विमूढात्मा इज व्हाट आत्मा इज नॉट विमूढा आत्मा इज अंतकरण देयर और रिफ्लेक्सिव और यू कैन से अंतकरण विमूढ आत्मयस्य सो विमूढ सॉरी विमूढ आत्मा यस्य सविमूढ आत्मा आत्मा इज अंतकरण एंड मिथ्याचार इज ऑल्सो बहुरी मिथ्या आचार अस्य यस्य स मिथ्याचार स उच्यते स मिथ्याचार उच्यते दैट पर्सन इज कॉल्ड एज मिथ्याचार बिकॉज ही इज इनफैक्ट अदर पर्सन इज एक्टिंग इट आउट व्यावहारिक सत्य इज इन्वॉल्व इन ही कंसिडर्स द वर्ल्ड एज रियल एंड इज एक्टिंग इट आउट बट दिस पर्सन इज इन एन इमेजिनरी वर्ल्ड सो ही इज इवन वर्स ही इज एंटरटेनिंग हिमसेल्फ बाय नॉट एक्टिंग बट ही इज डूइंग द सेम कर्म बट इमेजिनरी कर्म देयर बाय मिथ्याचार यह कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य संयम्य मनसा इंद्रियार्थान और इंद्रियार्थान मनसा स्मरण आस्ते संयम्य इंद्रियार्थान मनसा स्मरण आस्ते सह मिथ्या चारह उच्यते ही सेड टू बी मिथ्याचार ही इज कॉल्ड एज मिथ्याचार सॉरी फर्दर इन कंटिन्यूएशन यस्त्विंद्रियाणि मनसा नियम्य आरभते अर्जुन कर्मेन्द्रिये कर्मयोगम असक्तस्य विशिष्यते In continuation, in contrast rather, in contrast, yahatu, tu is giving the, on the other hand, yahatu, he Arjuna, Juna, yahatu, आरभते, आरभते वॉट, कर्मयोगम आरभते. सो यू लुक एट आरभते, आरभते इज ए वर्ब, यह तु आरभते, वन हु बिगिन्स, बिगिन्स वॉट, यह तु आरभते, बिगिन्स वॉट, ही बिगिन्स कर्मयोगम, कर्मयोगम आरभते, यह तु कर्मयोगम आरभते. हौ? इंद्रियाणि मनसा नियम्य, नियम्य आरभते. नियम्य इज लेबंता, हैविंग कंट्रोल्ड, अर्लियर संयम्य. सो संयम्य वॉट? कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य. एंड मनसा स्मरण, हियर मनसा इंद्रियाणि नियम्य. सो ही हैज इनर कंट्रोल एज वेल, क्षमा इज देयर. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ हैविंग दमा एंड नॉट हैविंग क्षमा, द अदर वे अराउंड, इफ अ पर्सन डज, वन एक्ट बट हैज क्षमा. दमा एज इन, दमा इज देयर, ही कैन कंट्रोल नॉट एज नॉट एक्टिंग, बट एज कर्मयोगा ही हैज टू डू. वेन बोथ, बोथ आर देयर, दमा एंड क्षमा बोथ आर देयर ड्यू टू चित्त शुद्धि, देन वन नीड नॉट एक्ट, दैट मे लीड टू संन्यास. बट हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अ पर्सन हु इज अ साधका, हु कैन ईदर एक्ट और नॉट एक्ट. सो इफ ही डज नॉट एक्ट, ही थिंक्स दैट आई एम ओके बिकॉज आई विल सिट आइडल. यू कैनॉट सिट आइडल बिकॉज गुणाज विल फोर्स टू एक्ट. इवन इफ गुणाज आर नॉट स्ट्रांग इनफ टू फोर्स यू टू एक्ट, एटलीस्ट यू फील, वन फील्स दैट वन रियली डज नॉट नो अनलेस वन विड्रॉज, अनलेस वन विड्रॉज फ्रॉम एक्शन, वन विल नॉट नो हाउ द माइंड कैन टॉर्चर अ पर्सन. Since a person is acting, see, you have a busy day, you ask a retired person or a person who has taken voluntary retirement or you know given up a job or whatever, you look at a child who is playing. This child wants to play at the cost of school. Now the school takes away this children have a lot of energy, but the school homework, going to school, coming back with these heavy bags, once the kid comes back home, wants to play, cannot play. But gunas are there, they want the kid to play. So the kid has energy, plays it out. But now once the school is over and vacation time is there, if the kid does not have enough children to play with, then the kid will get bored. So and parents know, kid will want more and more, something else to do. So the parents will say, you go out and play. Nobody is there, but you go out and play. Because the child can't remain, his mind is like that. It has so much of energy, but to play, it needs something. Similarly, a person who is retired also, the time and effort goes in the work that is assigned, and the mind is involved in that. So there is no torture there. But once a person is retired, and especially a workaholic, what will that person do sitting at home? Wants to act out, because the mind will start raising all sorts of questions, because the gunas are at play and dama may not be there, but the person has stopped acting because there is nothing to act out. We think that we can sit at home. You cannot sit at home. Therefore, the person has a choice to act or not to act. And as a sadhaka, it's always better to act, because otherwise the mind will not, the shama will not be there. So one has to develop shama with dama, along with dama. Therefore, in this first case, in the sixth shloka, one who remains without actually acting out the karma will be acting out within due to gunas being at play. And that person will become mithyachara. He will be fallen from the path. Otherwise, on the other hand, for chitta, till one earns chitta shuddhi, one has to act, and with Ishwara prasada buddhi and Ishwara arpana buddhi, if one acts, then karma yoga, due to that karma becoming yoga, the person will become a karma yogi, there will be chitta shuddhi, and thereby a person can go to jnana yoga. So here, yaha tu indriyani manasa niyamya arabhate. Arabhate what? Karma yoga marabhate. He actually starts with karma arabhate, but indriyani manasa niyamya, therefore ragadvesha is not there. Then this, with results also, there is this bhava that whatever comes is prasada, Therefore, one does not want the result to be this way or that way. Thereby, that karma now becomes karma yoga. Therefore, karma arabhate, but due to indriyani manasa sanyamya, that karma becomes karma yoga. Therefore, indriyani manasa niyamya, manasa niyamya, through the mind, one controls the indriyas, and thereby karma becomes karma yoga. Therefore, karma yoga arabhate. हे अर्जुन व्हाट हैपेंस देन असक्तः दैट सह असक्तः सन विशिष्यते विशिष्यते मीन्स ही एक्सेल्स ही इज सुपीरियर टू हूम टू द अर्लियर वन पर्सन हु इज नॉट एक्टिंग एंड एक्टिंग विद इन ही इज विदाउट एक्शन आउटसाइड बट ही इज विथ एक्शन or he is acting within. So one who is without action but acting within, compared to him, this asaktaha vishishyate. Asakta because this he has no asakti in karma really. Because he is offering it to the Lord. Thereby it has become karma yoga. He has no asakti in karma and karma phala anymore. And then slowly this ragadvesha having gone, indriyani manasa niyamya, this person is has become a karma yogi. चित्त शुद्धि इज द रिजल्ट टू फॉर दैट पर्सन एंड देयर फोर विशिष्यते ही इज सुपीरियर ही एक्सेल्स असक्त सन विशिष्यते आई एम नॉट मार्क द केसेस आई मार्क इट सम अदर टाइम आई थिंक इट्स क्लियर इंद्रियाणि मनसा ओके लेट्स फिनिश इट ऑफ कर्मेंद्रिये ही सॉरी कर्मेंद्रिये ही इज रिमेनिंग सो वी नो व्हाट इज मिस्ड सुनियम्य कर्मयोगम आरभते कर्मेंद्रिये ही कर्मयोगम आरभ्यते कर्मेंद्रिये ही कर्मयोगम आरभते हाउ अर्लियर वन हैज केप्ट कर्मेंद्रिय इन कंट्रोल दिस पर्सन इज लेटिंग द कर्मेंद्रियस गो एक्ट आउट बट ही हैज द इंद्रियाज अंडर कंट्रोल एंड थ्रू दोज इंद्रियाज हैविंग शमा Having Dhamma also, he knows what to do, up to what extent to do, and without basing his action on Raga and Dvesha. So, Karmendriye hi yaha tu indriyani manasa niyamya Karmendriye hi karma yoga maharabhate asakta san saha vishishyate. So, saha asakta san saha vishishyate. Yata evam ataha. Yata evam. यतः सिंस पंचम्य अर्थे तस्मिन् सो यस्मात् यस्मात् एवम् यतः और यस्मात् सेम मीनिंग सिंस एवम् इन दिस मैनर और सो अतः सिंस दिस इज सो अतः सिंस दिस इज सो मीन्स व्हाट सिंस इट इज ऑलवेज बेटर टू एक्ट फॉर अ साधका विथ ईश्वरार्पण बुद्धि एंड प्रसाद बुद्धि सो यू एक्ट ऑफरिंग एवरीथिंग दैट यू डू टू द लॉर्ड एंड टेक वॉट एवर कम्स एज अ रिजल्ट एज प्रसाद Thereby one becomes karma yogi and that karma yoga is better than karma or akarma also. Akarma as in what? What kind of akarma? Kevala sannyasa. Kevala sannyasa meaning without jnana. That is how it has started. So and that has taken cue from Arjuna who has said that I will take to bhikshacharya. So yata evam ataha since this person in the seventh shloka is better than the person in the sixth shloka. Therefore, नियतं कुरु कर्मत्वं कर्म ज्यायोह्य कर्मणः शरीर यात्रा पिचते न प्रसिद्ध्येत कर्मणः सो कुरु कर्म कुरु कर्म कुरु मध्यम पुरुष एकवचन एंड त्वम इज द कर्ता देयरफॉर कर्म हियर इज इन सेकेंड केस त्वम कर्म कुरु नियतं कर्म कुरु सो तुम नियतम कर्म दैट कर्म विच इज प्रिस्क्राइब बाय द शास्त्र एंड अंडर कंट्रोल सो व्हाट डज भाष्यकार से हियर नियतम कर्म नित्यम शास्त्रोपदिष्टम सो नियतम इज व्हाट नित्यम नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्म शास्त्रोपदिष्टम व्हाट शास्त्र टेल्स यू टू डू दैट कर्म यू डू यू गिव अप एनीथिंग एल्स यू गिव अप एवरीथिंग एल्स If you are a sadhaka, drop everything else. Me, everything else is what? That karma which is driven by raga dvesha. I will do this because I like to do. I will not do this because I do not like to do. And in shastras, what is that karma? It is kamya karma. Kamya karma means I want swarga. I want to avoid something else. I want dhanalabha ityadi. So for that, niyatam karma. And then if you do something which is wrong, then shastra says that okay, if you feel bad about what you have done, there is a prayaschita karma. So you do prayaschita karma because you do not want dukkha to come, or you don't want a lot of dukkha to come due to the papa karma which has been done in the past. So prayaschita karma you do. Pratyavaya dosha you avoid by nitya karma. So nitya karma you do, but prayaschita karma you drop off later. So kamya karma you drop off. Prayaschita karma also you drop off because let the papa which has gone by, let it take effect. Especially in the later stages of sadhana, a person gives a prayaschita also because he thinks that let this body go through suffering, that is another sadhana. Because you give unto prarabdha, you don't act against prarabdha because you become a karta by holding on to kartrutvam. This is at an advanced stage, but still you start by giving up kamya karma, sticking on to nitya naimittika karma, then slowly wean out from kamya karma so much so that you don't do ragadvesha prodded karmas also which are laukika. They may be neuter, as in shastra may be neutral to it. So karmas themselves may not be categorized as papa or punya, but you give those up because they are kamya, driven by ragadvesha, you give that up. Then what are you sticking to? Niyatam karma. Then over a period of time drop the prayaschita karma also. So niyatam, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says nitya shastra vihita karma. So shastra vihita karma kuru tvam. And why? And why is he saying karma kuru? Don't sit idle saying that I will not do. And shastra vihita karma for a kshatriya is to fight the battle that he finds himself in due to being born in a particular lineage, being a part of a particular army or whatever. Kshatriya is supposed to be devoted to that particular party, that particular vibhaga. So he is supposed to fight. Therefore, that is the vihita karma for Arjuna here. He, akarmanaha jayaha, compared to karma, jayaha, he, jayaha is neutral. And here, akarmanaha, jayaha, akarmanaha, compared to akarma, compared to not doing karma, meaning sixth shloka, the person who says that I'll not do karma. So that karma, not doing karma, is akarma. Compared to that sixth shloka akarma, karma in the seventh shloka is jaya, nitya karma. And then sharira yatra api cha te na prasidhyet akarmanah. So akarmanah, akarmanah te tava na prasiddhyet, there will be no prasiddhi, there will be no accomplishment of what? Sharira yatra will also not be accomplished. Sharira yatra cannot be accomplished. Whistling, it cannot be accomplished. If you just say that I'll not do anything, you will have to do something to keep yourself alive. So some karma you have to do. So last time I just said breathing. Breathing is automatic. But then, other than that, sustenance of the body is by karma alone. How will it remain otherwise? You have to eat at least. So eating, you have to pick up the food, earn the food, and then pick the food and eat. So all this is karma. Karmendriya sanyamya, you can't eat within your mind and be alive. You have to eat. So sharira yatra api akarmanah te sharira yatra api na prasiddhyet. It will not be possible to maintain your body also. Sharira yatra is yatra of the sharira. The progress of the sharira, this yatra is what? Being in the sharira itself is a yatra. You are continuing to survive in this body, and that itself is a travel, because that's why they say transmigration. Samsara is transmigration. So it need not be going from one body to the other. Even from the body of a child to a body of a young, and from young to an adult, and then from an adult to a middle age to old age, all that is, the sharira is different. You look completely different. People may not be able to recognize you, that this is how you looked at like a child. Or as an old man, you are different than how you were in middle age. So there is a lot of difference, because the body itself is different, it has changed, and that sharira yatra also will not take place unless you do karma. So this says, tvam niyatam karma kuru. Why? So he is yasmat. So we say akarmanaha, compared to not doing karma, karmaha jayaha. Jaya means superior. Jayaha karma he will say yasmat. Yasmat yataha akarmanaha karma jayaha karma jayaha tasmat. So he tataha we can add and say, therefore tataha tvam niyatam karma kuru. And this can also go as yataha sharira yatra api cha te sharira yatra te cha sharira yatra api na prasiddhet. Prasiddhet prasiddhet. So who is this akarmana? Now see, this akarmana and this akarmana is different. This akarma is karma. Karma is superior to non-performance of karma. So this is what? Non-action. Compared to non-action. Compared to non-action. What is this akarmanaha? Akarmanaha, you can say due to non-performance of karma. But this panchami is different from this panchami. Look at Bhashya. Sharira yatra is what? Sharira stiti hi. Api cha te tava na prasiddhyat prasiddhim na gachche. You will not attain accomplishment. Akarmanaha akaranat. Due to non-performance. So this akarmanaha, here it is what? Compared to non-action. And here this panchami is what? Due to hetau panchami. Due to non-action. So due to non-action, due to not doing any action, te sharira akarmanaha akarmanaha akaranat means akaranat, karma akaranat, akarmanaha te cha sharira yatra api na prasiddhet yachya manyase bandhartatvat karmana kartavyam iti tadapi asat. But Arjuna is thinking that if I perform action, especially his mind is influenced due to seeing these acharyas and pitamaha ityadi in the opposite side. So he is influenced by that, and he is thinking that this will lead to papa karma, killing them is papa, therefore I will not act, and that will bring bondage. Papa will bind me. Yachya manyase bandhartatvat karmana kartavyam. Karma should not be done. Any karma should not be done, because karma will bind. If that is the thinking, tadapi asat, that is also not true. Not all karma is binding. Which is a binding action? That action which is done for some phala, that I want this result as karma, not as karma yoga. With phala peksha, whatever karma is done, that phala can come for whom? For a karta. Bhoga is for a, see this bandhartha. Bandhartha is what? Bandha is what? Bhoga is bandha. The result that I have to endure, the result is bandha. And that bandha is due to taking myself as a karta. Being a karta, I cannot avoid bhoga. So if a person thinks, let me drop this karma itself, then I'll no longer be a karta, but I'll not have to be a bhokta, thereby bandhartha karma I'll drop. The karma will go away and thereby bandha will also go away. If that is the thinking, it is not true, because kartrutva bhava is there when you giving up karma. I am karta and I am karta of giving up of karma. Why? Because I think that I will not be a karta if I give up karma. That will not work. Just by giving karma, you will not become a non-karta, akarta. You can become an akarta only by jnana. Knowing that you are already akarta, karta cannot become akarta, really. Karma will become akarma only by knowing that you are already akarta, already a non-karta. That akarta in Sanskrit, nanj, and a in English, a in English, get mixed up. That's why I'll say non-karta and a non-karta or a karta. So I'll drop a itself. I'll say a person who thinks that I am karta. That person cannot become non-karta by just dropping karma, by just taking mere sannyasa, just what was said as nahi sannyasana deva siddhim vindati manava. So one will not get siddhi. What is said here, nahi sannyasana deva, see, siddhim samadhi gacchati. So that manava is in another shloka, nacha sannyasana deva. Just by dropping karma you will not get siddhi. Moksha will not come, which is akartrutvam, that will not come just by dropping karma. One has to have jnana, and that jnana cannot come without chitta shuddhi. For chitta shuddhi, karma has to be done. That karma cannot be done with raga dvesha, otherwise one will remain a karta and there will be no chitta shuddhi, because it will not be karma yoga. So karma yoga is superior to karma, akarma, which is dropping off of karma by an ajnani. Ajnani can drop karma, and ajnani cannot drop karma. Ajnani in fact does not have to drop karma. Jnani's karma is not karma. So here karma should not be dropped, because karma yoga is superior, and that person will get chitta shuddhi. And just by dropping karma, one will not become a non-karta, one will remain a karta. Therefore karma na kartavyam bandhartatvat iti tadapi asat yachya manyase. What you think, Arjuna, that I will drop karma because it brings bondage, that is not right, because that same karma will become the hetu for your mukti from bandha via chitta shuddhi. Katham yajnyarthat karmanonyatra lokoyam karma bandhanah tadartham karma kaunteya mukta sangas samachara. So samyak achara karma, he kaunteya karma samyak achara. Thereby you will become asangi, you will become, only when that asanga you become mukta sanga, kaunteya mukta sanga samachara. And what is that karma? That karma is what? Yajnyarthat karmana. That karma which is done for yajna. That karma which is done for yajna. What is that yajna? We'll see. But this karma that you are doing, which is karma yoga, which is nitya naimittika karma, just like for a brahmana, that ahuti in the nitya, for brahmana or dvija, for dvija the ahuti in, whether it is agnihotra karya or whether it is agni karya or agnihotra or agni karya, just the way that is yajna. Just like the bhojana is also yajna. The ahuti is pranahuti is given or chitrahuti is given, these are all yajna karya. Similarly, the karma yoga karma is also yajna. And yajnyarthat karmanah anyatra, other than that kind of karma, any karma which is not done as an offering to Lord, loka ayam karma bandhanah. Yajnyarthat karmanah anyatra, karmana is panchami here, other than that karma which is not done as yajna, ayam lokah karma bandhanah. This is karma, anything, any lokyate iti loka, that loka is karma bandhana, that is bondage. एंड तदर्थम कर्म कौन्तेय, तदर्थम इज व्हाट, यज्ञार्थम, यज्ञार्थम कर्म हे कौन्तेय मुक्त संग समाचर सम्यक आचर एंड दैट इज गोइंग टू लीड टू मुक्ति. जस्ट बिफोर वी डू दी अन्वया लेट्स लुक एट समथिंग इन दी भाष्य इफ यू कैन फाइंड समथिंग. सो ओके यज्ञार्थात, सो व्हाट इज दिस यज्ञार्थात, यज्ञो वै विष्णु. सो देर इज अ समिता, देर इज अ मंत्र यज्ञो वै विष्णु, यज्ञ इज इंडीड विष्णु इति श्रुते है, ड्यू टू दिस श्रुति वाक्य यज्ञ इज ईश्वर एंड हु इज दिस ईश्वर, यज्ञ इज ईश्वर, ईश्वर इज दैट सृष्टिकर्ता एज वेल एज द जगतकर्ता एज वेल एज दी. So not only the way we say that one who has created, maintaining and dissolving, but also karma phaladata. So he knows everything, he is sarvadhi sakshi bhutam. So tadartham yat kriyate, yajnartham karma. So ishwarartham yat kriyate, tad yajnartham karma. So what is that yajna? Yajna is Vishnu. So yajna is Vishnu, Vishnu is Ishwara, and Ishwara ईश्वरार्थम कर्म, फॉर ईश्वर आई एम डूइंग दिस कर्म एज एन ऑफरिंग अन टू द लॉर्ड, दैट कर्म इज कॉल्ड एज यज्ञार्थ कर्म. एंड तस्मात् कर्मणा अन्यत्र, यज्ञार्थात् कर्मणा अन्यत्र लोकः, अन्यत्र इज व्हाट, अन्येन कर्मणा, थ्रू एनी अदर कर्म लोकः अन्यत्र, सी अन्यत्र इज एन अव्यय सप्तमीय अर्थे त्रल, बट हियर भाष्यकार सेज अन्येन कर्मणा, अन्यत्र मीन्स थ्रू एनीथिंग एल्स. Through anything else means what? Through any other karma which is not done for the purpose of Ishvara, that is Yajna, Lokha Ayam Adhikrutaha Karma Krut Karma Bandhana. So Karma Bandhana is what? That person, Lokaha, will become. So Lokyateti Lokaha would be karma, but here it is Lokaha Ayam Adhikrutaha, one who is an Adhikari in that particular karma, Niyata Karma. So he is continuing from his earlier Bhashya, which is Niyatam is Nitya. नित्यम शास्त्रोपदिष्टम कर्म, द कर्म विच इज टॉट फॉर योर वर्णाश्रम, अदर देन दैट कर्म, एनी कर्म विच इज डन, पर्सन अयम अधिकारी, अयम अधिकृत मीन्स अधिकारी, हु इज एन अधिकारी इन दैट नियत कर्म, बट ही इज डूइंग नॉट डूइंग दैट कर्म, दैट नियत कर्म ही इज नॉट डूइंग, बट अन्यत्र मीन्स अन्येन कर्मणा, एनी अदर कर्म विच इज ड्रिवन बाय राग द्वेष, विच इज नॉट कर्मयोग, एंड देयर बाय अयम कर्म बंधन, कर्म बंधन इज व्हाट, कर्म बंधनम यस्य भौरी, बंधन इज ल्युट प्रत्यांत, यू कैन सी दिस अन, अन इज व्हाट, ल्युट योर अनाकौ, सो कर्म बंधन, बंध प्लस ल्युट विल बिकम बंध प्लस अन एंड दैट इज न्यूटर. सो कर्म बंध, कर्म बंधनम यस्य, यस्य लोकस्य, यस्य पुरुषस्य साधकस्य वा सह कर्म बंधन, दैट साधक इज नो लॉन्गर साधक बिकॉज ही इज डूइंग कर्म विच इज नॉट फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ यज्ञ, मीनिंग नॉट फॉर ईश्वर, बट ही इज डूइंग फॉर हिज ओन रागद्वेष, देयर बाय अयम लोक कर्म बंधन भवति. सो बंधार्थत्वात् कर्म न कर्तव्यम इति असत्, दैट इज रॉन्ग बिकॉज द सेम कर्म डन यज्ञार्थात ही विल बी फ्री, बट not doing that or doing that karma not for Ishvara but for oneself, ayam karma bandhana bhavati. And tadartham karma kaunteya mukta sanga samachara, let's look at what bhashyakara is, mukta sanga karma phala sanga varjitaha san, mukta sanga means what, sanga muktaha, sangat muktaha, you can't make that kind of an I'm just explaining the meaning, it is not sangat mukta but it is karma phala sanga varjitaha, he's saying mukta so it's tanta mukta sanghayasya, so mukta sanghayasya sa mukta sangha, and the meaning will be what, karma phala sangha varjita san samacharan, so nirvartaya, accomplish that karma, do that karma, mukta sangha will also be bahuri, just like our earlier bahuris. कर्म बंधना इज ऑल्सो बहुरी, हे कौन्तेय, सो हे कौन्तेय यज्ञार्थात कर्मणः अन्यत्र अयम् लोकः कर्म बन्धनः भवति तदर्थं कर्म हे कौन्तेय सुयसीन तदर्थं कर्म तदर्थं कर्म समाचर हौ मुक्त संग सन तदर्थं कर्म समाचर तदर्थं इज यज्ञार्थं कर्म समाचर इतश्च अधिकृतेन कर्म कर्तव्यम् अधिकृतेन पुरुषेण कर्म कर्तव्यम् इफ यू हैव एन अधिकारी इन पर्टिकुलर कर्म ड्यू टू योर वर्णाश्रम यू शुड डू दिस कर्म इतश्च मीन्स ड्यू टू दिस रीजन आल्सो इतः च तसिल इतः इदं प्लस तसिल ड्यू टू दिस रीजन आल्सो व्हाट इज दैट रीजन सह यज्ञः प्रजा सृष्ट्वा पुरोवाच प्रजापतिः अनेन प्रसविष्यध्वं एष वोस्तिष्ठकर्मधुक् सॉरी सह यज्ञः प्रजा सृष्ट्वा पुरोवाच प्रजापतिः अनेन प्रसविष्यध्वं एष वोस्तिष्ठकामधुक् सो इष्टकामधुक् वह सह यज्ञः प्रजाः सृष्ट्वा पुरा उवाच प्रजापतिः उवाच अनेन प्रसविष्यध्वं एष वह युष्माकं फॉर यू यह वह अस्तु इष्टकामधुक् कामधुक् इज अ उपपद तत्पुरुष एंड इष्ट इज काम इष्टकामधुक् इष्टकाम दोग्धि इति धुक् सो कामं दोग्धि इति कामधुक् इष्टकामं दोग्धि इति काम इष्टकामधुक् दि धातु इट इज अ द्विकर्मक धातु दि फॉर्म इज दोग्धि व्हेन यू डिक्लाइन इट दोग्धि मीन्स मिल्क्स व्हाट सो पर्सन कैन मिल्क अ काउ एंड ही कैन मिल्क मिल्क एज वेल देयरफॉर द्विकर्मक काउ इज ऑल्सो कर्म एंड मिल्क इज ऑल्सो कर्म सो इट्स अ द्विकर्मक धातु हियर इट इज कामधुक् इज वन हू सो यू सी यू हैव हर्ड इन पुराण कथा यू नो दैट द लवी इज ए कल्पतर वृक्ष सो देर इज अ कामधुक् ऑल्सो देर इज अ द काउ विच इज विश फुलफिलिंग सो इष्ट कामधुक् हियर not kamadhuk just a second let me see what bhashyakara says here ishtakamadhuk manhu kama ya dogdhi iti ishtakamadhuk karo so kaman ishtan is abhipretan ishtakaman ishtan kaman phala visheshan dogdhi iti one who milks what does one milk one is milking ishtakama whatever one desires one keeps on milking that through this life I want what I want that's it So that is one type. The other type is what? One who follows this yajñārtha karma. So taking cue from the earlier shloka. So itascha adhikritena karma kartavyam. Why should one do this karma which has been prescribed by the Vedas? Sahayajna prajapatihi. Prajapatihi pura uvacha. Earlier he has said. What has he said? Srishtva having created praja, the entire the praja that he created once having created this praja progeny sahayajnyah prajah srushtva so prajah he created the praja but what did he create along with that yajna yajnena sah यज्ञैः सह प्रजाः यज्ञैः सह यज्ञैः सह वर्तन्ते इति सह यज्ञाः प्रजाः दिस प्रजास आर नॉट क्रिएटेड जस्ट प्रोजेन जस्ट पीपल आर नॉट क्रिएटेड ही क्रिएटेड यज्ञ अलोंग विद देम बिकॉज प्रजा विल कंटिन्यू ओनली एंड दे विल कंटिन्यू वेल ओनली व्हेन यज्ञास आर डन सो हैविंग क्रिएटेड प्रजा अलोंग विद द यज्ञ प्रजापति सेड व्हाट डिड ही सेड से दैट इज सेड इन द नेक्स्ट श्लोक अनेन प्रसविष्यध्वम् एष वह अस्तु इष्टकामधुक् दिस पर्टिक्युलर यज्ञ दैट यू डू विल गिव यू वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट ऑल दिस पुरुषार्थास ऑल दी धर्मार्थ काम पुरुषार्थ विल एक्रू टू यू ओनली थ्रू यज्ञ एंड दैट यज्ञ इज वॉट वॉट एवर वैदिक कर्म इज गिवन टू यू Based on your division, whatever has been given to you, you do that, you will get, if you want dharma, you will get dharma, if you want artha, you will get artha, if you want kama, you will get kama, if you want moksha, you will get moksha. So he said, anena prasavishyadvam, and if you want moksha, still you cannot give up karma. You have to do karma, earn chitta shuddhi and gain moksha. So for this reason also, not only because earlier it was said that, थ्रू चित्त शुद्धि यज्ञार्थात कर्मणः अन्यत्र लोकायम कर्म बंधन एंड इफ यू थिंक दैट यू विल गेट अवे यू लेट्स से यू से आई डोंट वांट मोक्ष देन आल्सो यू हैव टू डू दिस बिकॉज इवन इफ यू डोंट वांट मोक्ष यू डोंट वांट पापा यू वांट टू अवॉइड प्रत्यवाय दोष देयरफॉर आल्सो यू हैव टू डू कर्म एंड नाउ ही इज सेइंग दैट वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट यू विल गेट ओनली थ्रू दिस यू कैन नॉट गिव अप द कर्म एंड ट्राई टू गेट वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट यू विल नॉट गेट In a short term, you may think so, but in the long term, you will lose even what you have. Therefore, anena prasavishyadvam, esha vaha, esha yajnyaha vaha, yushmak, for you all, astu ishtakamaduk. Let it be ishtakamaduk, let it be like a wish-fulfilling cow. So that's why he has given these yajnyas. So you look here. Saha yajnya, yajnya sahita prajaha, trayaha varnaha, taha srushtva, utpadya, pura, पूर्वम सर्गाद उवाच पुरा इज वॉट पूर्व इन दि एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द क्रिएशन इट सेल्फ ही सेड उक्तवान प्रजापति ही प्रजापति हुज ब्रह्मा ब्रह्मा हु चतुर्मुख ब्रह्मा हु क्रिएटेड दिस वर्ल्ड एंड देन अनेन यज्ञेन प्रसविष्यद्वम इज वॉट प्रसव वृद्धि उत्पत्ति तम कुरुध्वम लेट इट ब्रिंग अबाउट ग्रोथ ही सेड लेट इट ब्रिंग अबाउट प्रसव प्रसव इज वॉट ग्रोथ उत्पत्ति तम कुरुध्वम लेट इट मेक लेट इट ब्रिंग ग्रोथ एंड एष यज्ञ वह युष्माकम अस्तु भवतु इष्ट कामधुक लेट इट बी दिस यज्ञ इटसेल्फ लेट इट बी समथिंग विच इज विल ब्रिंग योर मेक योर विशेस कम ट्रू सो आई जस्ट मेक एन अनवे एंड विल स्टॉप प्रजापति ही वाच व्हाट डिड ही से एंड प्रजापति ही वी कैन से सह यज्ञाः प्रजाः सृष्ट्वा प्रजा इज स्त्रीलिंग एंड लाइक रमा दिस इज कर्म द्वितीय बहुवचन पुरा उवाच प्रजापतिः अनेन प्रसविष्यध्वम् एषः वः अस्तु इष्टकामधुक् सो प्रजापति सहयज्ञः प्रजाः सृष्ट्वा उवाच व्हाट डिड ही से सो विल से एषः अनेन यज्ञेन प्रसविष प्रस अर्थम एंड एषः वह इष्ट कामधुक अस्तु एंड यू कैन से इति उवाच यू कैन ऐड इति उवाच दिस इज व्हाट ही टोल्ड एवरीवन एंड कथम फर्दर विल सी कथम हाउ इज इट सो दैट विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ओम तत्सत् एनी क्वेश्चंस Yes, sir.
In the previous shloka, can you I didn't understand the second part of the sentence. Mukta sangha mukta sangha santadarsam karma samasara.
So mukta sangha is sangha varjita. So being free from attachment that I'll do this karma or I'll not do this karma. Both are attachments. Actually, attachment is in the form of I want this result, I don't want this result. So that is one attachment. Other will be that I'll not do this karma because I don't like and I'll do this karma because I like. That is also an attachment. So mukta sangha san, being bereft of such attachments to phala or to karma, tadartham karma samachara. Tadartham is yajna artham. Do it as an offering unto the Lord. Does that answer the question?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. There's one more shloka before. Think it was 3-6. Here, Indriyani, he's talking about Jnana Indriyani when he.
Not Indriyani, Jnana Indriyani, Karma Indriyani, Sayamya.
No, later, when the second part of the sentence where you're talking about. My question is actually even if it's not explicitly mentioned, then it must imply that it is Jnanendriyana for the second part.
This can include both karma and jnana. But finally, when you are indulging mentally, there will be jnanendriyas. Now, let's say you like cricket, for example. Okay. And you say, I'll not play cricket. You want to control yourself. Okay, so karmendriyani sanyam. You will not go out and you will not, lift up a bat and you will not kick around. So, whatever. So, you will be controlling your karmendriyas. Now, when you are acting it out in the dream or when you just daydream, you say that you are watching the match. You are not playing, but you are watching the match and you say, oh, I would have done this. I think I have hit a whatever sixer or whatever. So that thinking that I am playing, you are indulging in the action, and that is, although it is mental, you will be imagining yourself with the body mind sense complex. You will have a sharira also, right? So think of a dream. Daydreaming is also like a dream. That's why it's called a daydream, right? You are not acting out with your body. External sense or this karmendriyas, you are not acting out, but you are imagining those karmendriyas to act. So will you call them these indriyarthas? Whether these indriyarthas are the cricket accessories, those accessories are indriyartha. Whether those are accessories to your karmendriya or jnanendriya is irrelevant there. Okay, because subtly you are indulging and your karmendriyas are also acting because you think. See, karmendriyas are actually indriyas are subtle. They are not the organs themselves, right? They are not the hands and legs. It is the locomotive organ. It is the organ with which you grasp something with your hands. When you grasp, the ability to grasp may or may not be there when hands are there. When hands are not there, the ability to grasp is still there because you can grasp through you with some other organ. So one can do what the hand does through the leg also, one may be able to do. But that power that the sense organ, the hand has, that is there although the hand is not there. And the person can use the leg to grasp. So the power to grasp is called as the hastendriya. So if you compare that, then that way the karmendriya subtly also, if you are using those indriya, then it can be karmendriya. Okay. So this indriya arthan can be any of those, but you are right that mostly it will be since it is mentally manasa smaran, it will be jnanendriya. Because even if karmendriyas are there, this karmendriya's interaction is through the jnanendriya, because it will be subject to jnanendriya finally. The shabda, shabda sparsha rasa, all the rupa rasa gandha. So.
I think in the next shloka
it is just given as indriya. It can be general. Sorry, what were you saying?
In the next shloka, actually, Krishna is saying that you should control the mind and then go out and still act. So I think this is what I had asked you before about this catch 20. You had explained this, the catch 22.
Yeah.
In the sense that, okay. So the catch 22 remains and Krishna doesn't solve it for us.
See,
in the sense
you have
that
to begin somewhere. See, how does it will get resolved. See, what are the steps? The steps will finally lead to karma, sarva karma sannyasa. See, moksha is the goal. Moksha is jnana. Jnana can take place in where there is chitta shuddhi. Jnana and karma cannot go together. So what do we know by that? So far we know that moksha is through jnana. Jnana and karma cannot go together. Therefore, karma has to be dropped. So sarva karma sannyasa is the goal. If sarva karma sannyasa is the goal, then can I do karma sannyasa now? Karma sannyasa means just dropping karma. Can I do that? That is the question. So he says you cannot do that because you will never reach the goal. To reach the goal, you have to have jnana. And jnana will come in a mind which has chitta shuddhi. For chitta shuddhi, karma has to be done. What kind of karma? Karma yoga. So you have to give up karma by taking to karma yoga. So you have to give up. So what is the path? Give up kamya karma. Drop all the ragadvesha driven karma. Stick on to nitya naimittika karma. I mean, this is all not, it is a path, a journey which over a period of time you keep on. It is not digital. The world is not digital. You can't just get up one morning and say, okay, I am giving up all my raga dvesha. You can't do it. So slowly you move from kamya karma on to karma yoga. Then through karma yoga, chitta shuddhi. And then he says you drop that also when you have sufficient chitta shuddhi for shravana. Otherwise, better still, he says you continue to do only nitya naimittika karma as karma yoga, and then once you have a vision that you are akarta, you have understanding and you are clear that you are akarta, then you can drop. So it does not remain catch 22 then. That is how it is solved.
Okay.
Otherwise, it will always remain, there will be dependency. But we had talked about what? I think the catch 22 situation was in.
Catch 22 was in how to give up.
How to give up? I think we had taken an example of sweet.
Yeah.
So between that rasa remaining and not acting.
Correct.
So it will go only when you give up, but then that giving up is a journey itself. So it should not be giving up the way the sixth sloka talks about, but it should be the way seventh sloka talks about. So through this seventh sloka only you can go to the next step. Okay. Anything else? Anyone else? You had something, Anand?
No, I just wanted to say Sudhi hasn't got back to me yet, so
okay, I mean,
we'll get back to you about that.